won't be like that, but our future will be quite a different place. Instead of one global superpower, we will see a new worldwide governance system, such as the UN or the EU. This system will eradicate the need for one global superpower and make the term empire irrelevant. After its fall from the position of global hegemon, the US will be forced to cut military spending and slowly pay back loans. Our economy will slowly stabilize and we will develop sustainable technologies and once again become prosperous. Following the mold of many other nations, our transportation systems for the growing urban areas will become more efficient. We may see high-speed bullet trains like the Japanese already have, or perhaps some other form of rail system much more efficient than our own. Suburban transportation will remain independent. Personal vehicles aren't going anywhere quickly. However, in our new US, we will see much smaller, efficient vehicles that run on electricity, hydrogen, or a new clean fuel. To develop domestic energy sources, our nation will look into plenty of alternative energy sources. But the most exciting progress will be made in joint efforts to develop new energy sources such as fusion power. These shared power plants will develop plenty of energy to be shared amongst nations. Urbanization will increase even more and we will have no place left to go but up. To feed all these condensed people, faraway Midwest farms will not suffice. Agricultural potential will be restored in the form of indoor farming right in the heart of our cities. An increase of focus on education systems will hopefully result in new leaders who will be able to optimize our legal system and develop effective taxation strategies.
Our future in the end could be bright, but it may take the fall of our empire and the fall of all empires to promote a cooperative future and a successful global empire.